it's Joey for Digital DJ Tips, and I've got my Rekordbox cap on because, you guessed it, we're going to be taking a look at Rekordbox 5.0 in this video. Rekordbox 5.0 is the latest update to Pioneer DJ's music management and DJ performance software. Now, we gave you a sneak peek of this app a couple of weeks back via the Rekordbox 5.0 beta, and now Pioneer DJ has officially released the final version of the app. So in this video, we're going to do two things. First up, I'm going to give you a features rundown of Rekordbox 5.0, and then I'm going to give you my thoughts on this software. Let's go. We'll take a look at the new features of Rekordbox 5.0 in this review, but first, let's take an overview of Rekordbox. Rekordbox has two modes. The first is export mode. This is where you prepare your music and playlists for export to a USB thumb drive, which you'll then use with a compatible CDJ or XDJ setup. Transferring songs this way lets you analyze and manage your tunes ahead of time, and lets you prep individual tracks such as adding memory locations and hot cues. If you DJ with a thumb drive using CDJs or XDJs, this is the mode that you'll use the most. The second mode is performance mode. It's enabled by purchasing the Rekordbox DJ add-on. Performance mode lets you DJ with your laptop connected to a Rekordbox DJ compatible device, such as a DJ controller or DJ media player. Some of the new features in Rekordbox 5.0 affect both export and performance modes. Let's go through them right now. First up, Rekordbox 5 has a new graphic interface. It's got a flatter look compared to its predecessors and has crisper fonts. The fonts are also adjustable, which is great for DJs who have bad eyesight, such as myself. The colorway is a lot simpler too. Gone are the dull gray hues of past Rekordboxes. You've now got a black, blue, and white color scheme that makes text and graphics pop out more, which is great for DJing in both dim clubs and outdoors. The next new feature is the 16 total hot cues and memory locations. That gives you more cue points than ever before, which could make for some interesting cue juggling routines. When used in performance mode, the 16 hot cue maximum lets you take full advantage of the DDJ XP1 grid pad controller, which has two sets of 16 pads on it. The third new feature is the ability to import tracks and playlists from a USB stick that were exported from another Rekordbox collection. That means that you can take your thumb drive and use it with another laptop running Rekordbox. Or maybe you're doing a back-to-back set with a friend and you're using a laptop. He can just plug in his thumb drive containing music exported from his Rekordbox collection, and he can then import those songs and playlists to your laptop to DJ off of it. The last new feature is exclusive to performance, and this feature is the new keyboard and key shift pad modes. Keyboard lets you pitch up and pitch down a hot cue, perfect for pitch play routines, while key shift allows you to quickly shift the musical key of a track that you've got loaded up or down. This allows you to key match a song to a track that's already playing. Alright, so what are my thoughts on Rekordbox 5.0? Well, first up, I really like the new interface. I love the new look. It's flatter, it's slicker, and it just looks really good. You could be DJing in a dark environment, say in a club or a bar, and it's very easy to spot tracks in your library as well as see the virtual decks. You could also be DJing outdoors, and you won't have a problem seeing the interface. Now, as I mentioned, I have really poor eyesight. That's why I wear these thick glasses, and I do appreciate the fact that you can increase the size of the fonts over in Rekordbox, and the fonts themselves are even a lot crisper compared to previous versions of Rekordbox. I've been using Rekordbox since version 3, and I've got to say, Rekordbox 5.0 has the nicest looking interface out of the entire lot. So, good job, Pioneer. Now, the second thing that I liked about Rekordbox 5.0 are the new performance options found in Rekordbox DJ. There are two new pad modes, keyboard and key shift, and I think controllerists and turntablists are going to love these because it'll allow them to create more complex routines and it could augment their performances, especially when used with the DDJ XP1 grid pad controller. That's going to make for some really crazy pitch play, tone play, and all sorts of other player cue point juggles that you're going to be able to do during a performance. Now, the third thing that I liked about Rekordbox 5.0 is the ability to store your entire music library on an external hard drive and use that hard drive on other laptop computers. That means that you aren't tied to your own laptop if in case you're going to be DJing from an external hard drive. That's a big convenience because you used to be tied to the same laptop that you used to organize your Rekordbox collection if you're using an external hard drive. So again, very, very convenient, especially if you do a lot of traveling and you don't want to take your laptop along with you wherever you go. Now, the only thing that I didn't like about this version of Rekordbox is that it has a couple of annoying bugs in it that need to be squashed soon as possible. The most glaring one, or the biggest bug, so to speak, is the inability to use the performance pads of the DJM S9 battle mixer. Now, a lot of battle DJs are interested in Rekordbox. However, there hasn't really been a flagship mixer that they could use for their scratch routines, so they're still using Serato DJ. They do want to try Rekordbox DJ out, so Pioneer said, okay, we're going to give you Rekordbox DJ compatibility with a DJM S9. But at the moment, the performance pads don't work and they crash once in a while, so that's kind of annoying. Now, another annoying bug that I've noticed is that I get these intermittent stutter sounds whenever I drop a track using my DDJ RZ. I tried it out at a gig last week, and man, it was a bit of a nightmare. I had to restart Rekordbox 5. I tried opening Rekordbox 4 and just doing my set, and what happened was the DDJ RZ itself froze. So I don't know if it's like a software issue or if the DDJ RZ needs a firmware update. I've already got it loaded to the latest firmware and I still had this issue. So what I had to do that time was I had to restart my laptop and unplug my controller again and just plug everything back in and restart. That took a total of like, what, 5 or 6 minutes. And it's a good thing I had a pre-made mix on my phone that I just played for the time being when I sorted those technical issues out. Now, I was sweating behind the booth, kind of embarrassing, but these things happen, I guess. And well, that's what you get for trying out a new piece of software right after it gets launched, right? So there you go. Pioneer DJ, please fix that ASAP. So that's it for this talkthrough of Rekordbox 5.0. I've got a full detailed review of it over at the Digital DJ Tips website. The link to that is in the description box below. Please hit the thumbs up icon if you like this video and hit the subscribe button if you are not a subscriber yet. My name is Joey. Thank you for watching. I'm gonna see you next time.